In this animated presentation, we will look at how to overhaul typical automobile starting motor. We will go through disassembly, inspection, repair and or replace the parts, reassembly and finally performance testing. Remove two nuts of magnetic switch. Remove the lead wire nut from the magnetic switch and disconnect the lead wire. Then take out the magnetic switch, such that the inside hook is disconnected from the drive lever. Now, remove the housing bolts, also known as through bolts. Pull out the rear housing. Remove insulator that hold the brushes and springs in place. Then take out the brush springs, and the brush holder after that. Now yoke assembly having stator coils can be removed. Pull out the front drive housing and then the drive lever. Draw pinion stop ring toward overrunning clutch side and remove snap ring. Then pull out the pinion stop ring. Pull out the overrunning clutch assembly from the armature. We start our inspection process with the magnetic switch, also known as solenoid. Inspect plunger for wear. Replace if necessary. Pull out the plunger and release it. The spring inside, move the plunger back to its original place quickly. If not, replacement is necessary. There are two coils inside the magnetic switch, the pull-in and the hold-in coil. The pull-in coil connects between the S and M terminals, the hold-in coil connects between S terminal and ground through coil case. Check for continuity across magnetic switch S and M terminal. If no continuity exists, pull-in coil is open and should be replaced. Check for continuity across magnetic switch S terminal and coil case. If no continuity exists, hold-in coil is open and should be replaced. Measure the length of carbon brushes and compare them with the manufacturer recommended value. Replace if they worn out too much. Check for the continuity between lead wire brushes. If no continuity exists, lead wire along with brushes should be replaced. There are two stator coils. Each coil has two windings. One end of each coil is body grounded and the other end is connected to the carbon brush. Check for the continuity between field coils carbon brushes. Continuity should exist. Otherwise the whole yoke assembly need to be rewind or replaced. Next we will perform armature ground test. Between commutator segments an armature core should be insulated and no continuity should exist. Check for continuity between the consecutive commutator segments. If there is no continuity at any test point, there is an open circuit and whole armature is to be replaced. Check commutator for runout with armature supported on V-blocks and compare out of round value with the manufacturer recommendations. Correct it by using lathe if required. Check for wear and replace armature if diameter is below the prescribed manufacturer limit. The power is transmitted through the splines on shaft, meshes with the internal splines of outer race of overrunning clutch. When the outer race is rotated, the rollers get trapped between outer and inner race and transfer power to pinion. When engine gets started and drives pinion at high speed, the rollers get released and power transfer is stopped. Hold the outer race of overrunning clutch and rotate the pinion in reverse direction of drive. The pinion should rotate smoothly in reverse direction. Now, when pinion is rotated in the direction of drive, it should locks up. Shaft is supported at either ends with the help of brass bushes. Rock the front and rear housings back and forth. If the play is too much, the bushes have been worn out and new bushes are to be installed. Reassembly is in the reverse order of disassembly. Except, greasing of some components before installing. Before installing overrunning clutch, apply grease to splines and shaft. Use new snap ring. Apply grease to drive lever, then, apply grease to front housing brass bush. Apply grease for rear housing brass bush. Apply grease to the plunger of magnetic switch before installing. Connect the battery positive terminal with B and S terminals of magnetic switch as shown. Connect the negative terminal of the battery with the casing. The pinion should first move forward and then revolve.